Hey guys, it's Brooke Capers, and welcome back to my FIFA 60 in Liverpool for my World Arsenal. Walked off, I beat Sheffield Wednesday in the FA Cup, and I defeated Aston Villa in the league. As if I have two more matches, as usual. Well, first up is Spurs at White Hart Lane, which will be the third time in less than a week that I've played Spurs, because I, of course, played them not too recently in the final few videos of my Marseille career mode. If you've not seen the end of the Marseille career mode, go watch. It is a very interesting watch.
Welcome to you all. I'm Martin Tyler, Alan Smith is with me. As always, we'll try not to make any slips in the commentary, but there might be some slips out on the pitch, Alan, in these wet conditions.
Yeah.
I don't think it's going to stop during the course of the match, so I don't think it's going to affect the game in any way in terms of calling it off, but it might get...
I just want to say, apologies for back-to-back days of Liverpool Chrono, but I explained my reasoning for there not being another secondary career mode. And for those who didn't watch, I think it was the last secondary career mode episode, which was the last Marseille career mode video. I'll say it again. I did have a La Liga career mode planned, but unfortunately, due to time restrictions, I wouldn't be able to fit the whole season in. I did come playing streaming it, but then I said, I might have to be done on two different days, and I
just off target.
Said, you know what? Considering who I was, I can just say, you know, I would probably won La Liga. I'm not just saying that because, you know, I am that damn good career mode. The team that had been randomly selected, it was Barcelona, so yeah.
In the goal charts,
well, they play such an open.
Chances were probably good that I was gonna win.
Looking there, Townsend.
Do I need to be good at the game and to win with Barcelona? You just have to be competent. I guess that could be said for a few teams, like Real Madrid could be classed in the same category as well. Of course, Barcelona aren't perfect. No team is.
Punched away by the goalkeeper. Well, as blocks go, that's a good one.
All these deflections. One of these will go in, but they don't seem to want to, fortunately.
Nathaniel Klein. Here's Cristiano Ronaldo.
If you missed the previous episode and wondering why Nicholas Sewell is playing instead of Amerikah Laporte, is because he picked up a suspension to Laporte, and so he's filling in.
Well, that is another corner. Well, the goal not given, Alan, and we can see why now.
Yeah, and as we all know, Martin, the whole of the ball has got to cross the line, and it clearly doesn't.
Here comes the cross.
Shots on here.
Well, he put the signal up there, but I don't think the teammates recognized it. Broke down anyway.
I mentioned that I was gonna stream yesterday, but I didn't. I mean, not yesterday, today. I was gonna stream today if I did decide I was gonna do the Barcelona career mode in stream, but I decided against it. But tomorrow, the FIFA 17 demo should be out, so you will get a stream of that. I don't know how long the stream will be. Chances are there will be other streams and other videos and such and whatnot. Chances are I will be hosting like a little mini FIFA 17 demo tournament between the teams that are in the demo. Have the chance to tune in. That'll be probably from like early tomorrow.
And the offender's going to get a yellow card.
Yeah, I wonder whether he thought he got away with it.
Once it becomes midnight and the game officially releases, I can actually get my hands on it and, well, the demo version of it, and I can get a feel for it. Also, the Germany is on the demo, so that should be interesting. Not sure how I'm supposed to test out the Germany when there are only three Premier League teams in the frickin' demo. That's Chelsea, East City, and United. Man United, Man City, I should specify, because there are other cities and United in the league. Liverpool were supposed to be in the demo, but they got taken out for some reason. And Dortmund, and Barcelona, weirdly.
Oh, and goes across.
Not sure why, but I'm sure EA have their reasons, other than the fact that they're biased as hell. Not sure why they're biased against Barcelona. Maybe it has something to do with why Messi isn't the highest rated player when he should be. I don't care what the hell Ronaldo won. With Portugal, even though Ronaldo didn't do jack shit in the Euros. And come on, be realistic, he didn't. He scored 2 goals against Hungary. That's it. What did he do in the rest of the tournament? Nothing. And he got injured in the final. That was Ronaldo's Euros. And that's combined with him winning the Champions League. Oh, that warrants him having a higher rated card than Messi. What a load of bull.
Ronaldo! Great stop. Yet another corner. Goes for it with a fist. And here's the shot. And they manage.
Oh, what a goal from Bale.
Liverpool have got the goal. The goalkeeper did his very best, but I think he might have regrets that he...
That is just beautiful from the Express player. They were freaking... They were not... They did not want to give up the deadlock. But I broke it.
Cristiano Ronaldo!
Ah!
That would have ensured the victory, I think. But he's missed it. Well, they've been the better side by far.
The hell was that, Cristiano?
And Herrera.
Great passing. And the crowd really enjoying it.
able to ease the pressure. Well, the flag's up.
Yeah, just ignore her everything. Oh, it was offside. That's why now my players just were reacting to me. Me telling them what to do. I just thought it was the game. I'm used to the game doing that now. Thankfully, hey, I can.
It's
only a few more weeks and then finally FIFA 17.
The shot's on! Well blocked. It's behind for another corner.
I would happily put. I would happily pay double for the game if EA released it tomorrow. So, EA, if you're watching this, release FIFA 17 tomorrow, and I'll happily pay double for my copy.
What about this impacting on the next?
Just inform the GameStop I've pre-ordered it from.
Well, nobody's played well for them. They've got to do better. He might be through. Cross coming in now. Cristiano Ronaldo.
And I'll collect it in the morning.
And it's back for a corner again.
You know, you think I'd be worried that they might actually see this, but of course they won't, because why the fuck should they care? Some Irish who playing their game, and who's been playing their game consistently for almost 17 years.
From the player when he could have easily passed it.
It's not important. I'm not important. We as
read the situation perfectly with that interception.
Customers and fans of the game are not important. But what is important is getting the 3 points in this match. Moving on to the game against Wolves. Making, I guess, second goal. Neymar's up. Parts the defender, but Lloris smutters Neymar's attempt at a shot.
Really bad weather today. Really good game.
But it is not good enough. Because the goal from is the winning goal. And Chelsea lost. Fantastic. That means they are even further behind me now. 24 points to be precise. Yeah! Oh, life is good. It's a bit conflicting, you know what I mean? I want Chelsea to keep losing points, but I don't want them to fall out of second, because then I'll be wanting someone else to lose points. It's a tricky one, is it? It is. Tricky. Tricky, tricky, tricky. Very, very tricky. Like I had prestige. All I could I mentioned this in my final video on my Marseille for another hour. Rarely I use my substitutions. It's a bit odd, but not unheard of to not use your substitutions. Mitch Chow is going on a 2-year loan to the Nottingham Forest. That is fantastic, because they will actually play him. Yeah, I know, crazy concept. Actually loaning a player to a team that are actually going to play him. I know, I didn't think I could actually manage it either. But Nottingham Forest should play him in almost every match. Unfortunately, it's halfway through the goddamn season, but hey. One thing at a time. No. That's not even attentive to the value. Ooh. that. More money, yay! I assume that means I can look and see who I have in the next round of the FA Cup? Coventry. Sandwiched between the semi-final against Chelsea. Both legs. To be precise. Oh yes, I'm away first. Fantastic. That gives me the chance to get away goals, but that will be in the next episode. Which, for the record, is going to be recorded straight after this, so... Like, I mean, immediately. I mean, yeah, I am back to college on Wednesday, which means we're back to a scheduling uploads. It'll be just for Wednesday and Thursday, though. So, today's video was recorded on the day it goes up, and tomorrow's video will be the live stream, because I'll be streaming directly to YouTube. Because why the hell not? Because I can't figure out how to get my streams from Twitch to YouTube, so I said, you know what, fuck it. I can stream to YouTube, why not just do that? I've never done it, so I don't know what it's gonna be like. I know YouTube can cause a little few problems, apparently, and the chat can be a bit irritating. And it's gonna be interesting. It's gonna be an experiment, to say the very least. Hey, if it works, it might happen again. If it doesn't, it won't happen again. Simple as that, really.
Rodriguez in the fullback positions. Felipe Coutinho starts.
What I do want to happen again is another win. Chelsea could maybe just drop the 1 point. I mean, they'd stay second even if they lost, because Newcastle are 4 points behind them, not three.
Price.
1 point would be important. This is okay in my book. That's still 2 points dropped on their half.
It's good vision to be able to switch the play there.
Of our deal. The deal, they don't even know what's what is in effect. But they're doing that far anyway. Fine. That's it back. Technic. Mar Ronaldo. Yes! Somehow snuck it in!
Superb goal here.
See this again. Nathaniel Klein pulls it back. And Neymar hits it straight at the keeper. Oh, Ronaldo slotted it in. I thought. Oh, it hit the post! It came back. It. Oh, it went in. What a massive amount of luck! He won't care. 29 goals. Plus, he's now 10 off, equaling the record that he set last season. He's well on his way to getting a second top goal scorer award.
Coutinho.
Which again is pretty much unheard of. This career mode, at least.
It is a cheap piece of play to give the ball away like that. Nathaniel Klein. Well, we've got a free kick here. Referee points for it.
Right.
Nathaniel Klein.
Nathaniel Klein.
Ronaldo!
Neymar is offside. That's not who I wanted it to pass to. The game fucked me over. I was trying to pass to T. Coutinho, I was holding the thing and all. Well, for fair that it might do that. But it didn't end.
Because the pass wasn't really a very thoughtful one.
That's a nice bit of skill, but the defending, well, it was woeful. Coutinho!
Coutinho, there we go. That makes up for it, kind of. Coutinho does get his goal, although he probably should have gotten a few minutes earlier if not for the game. He's trying to fuck me over, but hey, it's 2-0. And we're already having a much better game than trying to break down the wall of Tottenham.
He's moved in trying to jostle the free kick here.
Wait, what happened? Wait, what the hell happened? I didn't know anything.
This is the sort of side
I tried to win the ball. Since when is that a foul?
They are. I mean, they've not been fazed at all by being top. Sometimes it can affect teams.
I almost want to watch that back to actually see what the hell a foul was given for. But I'll take 3 now.
Dead. Comes with the territory. He had no choice. He had to play the ball, but it's ended up in the back of his own net.
Oh, it was an own goal. I thought it took a knock off one of the heads. I didn't know where it was Ronaldo or the defender. I probably should have known it was the defenders because Bale was the one celebrating. If it was Ronaldo, he would have been celebrating.
Wasting time here. Rafael.
Sorry, I had something in my throat. Took a drink of water. Make sure. Plus, I didn't want to cough into the mic.
He cleared that really well. That's cleared out of play. It'll be a corner. Alan, let's go back.
Aaron Hino. Not having the best day. Pretty good header, to be fair to him. It's not exactly something he'll want to praise on.
Got up well for that header. Over the top.
Yeah, he found some space, didn't he? Couldn't quite do the hard part, though.
See what difference having Ronaldo and Bale in the box makes.
And the time to be added on here is,
I don't know why it was trying to say they'd be better off taking the goddamn corners.
Coutinho. There goes the cross. And that's a goal that only increases their...
I mean, if Ronaldo's not in the box, he can't do stuff like that. He is a threat in the box, as is Bale. Their height and power makes them a threat to any defense. Especially... He was, as Wolves don't seem to have an answer for it. See... Chelsea are drawing, look at that! That's fantastic. Go on, Swansea.
At Anfield, the second half is now underway. Now Doherty.
That'd be a bit like real life. In real life, Chelsea and Swansea play at the Liberty and drew 2-2. Maybe that's how they are in-game match will finish.
Decisively. Here we'll see what we
corner. Thank you very much. Continue on it and he'll take it. It's come to Bale. Ooh! I thought the same thing happened and that happened against Spurs. This was just wide of the mark. Hit the back pole thing. That looks connected to the goals.
How do you think Cristiano Ronaldo did in the first half, Alan?
On top of his game out there, and I'm sure he'll be thinking about grabbing his hat-trick in the second half.
It's a turnover in play. Great work by the goalkeeper. Ball is his, and he's made sure he's protected it. Rafael.
Right. Nathaniel Klein. Good ball to Bale. Put it in. For some reason it went over and out of his head. That's okay. He'll take a corner.
Comes the forward who's not got very far.
Something's going off.
In their pockets.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought Varane connected perfectly. No, just over the bar. That's a shame.
Push for you in the direction of EA Sports presentation of the semi-final first leg Capital One Cup fixture. Liverpool, they'll be facing Chelsea away from home.
Now, can he or they will deal with that? Yes, he will. Oh! Currently, he dealt with so. Oh, it took a deflection and went out over a goal kick. Brilliant. Okay, now, of course, you know what happened.
That's very comfortable. A pass.
Hey! Thank you.
Rafael Varane. Throw in here.
You know what I just realized?
Now Doherty. Wallace.
Dortmund not being on the demo. The cover star of FIFA is not in its demo.
For this upcoming.
What the ever loving fuck? Why replace Messi as the cover star if Royce isn't in the demo either?
From a long, 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 long way out.
I'm sure his manager.
I mean, why did Dortmund get moved? I know I moved on from the subject, but it just popped into my head as I was looking at Royce and like, hang on, Royce is still at Dortmund. So, them taking Dortmund out of the demo means the cover star of the game isn't in the demo. That's just, that's messed up. That'd be like having... It'd be like having a Batman game and Batman not being in. Or any other game, set on player. I know FIFA 17 isn't set on Marco Royce. I know there is no
was not the best of challenges.
Out main character, but Marco Royce being on the cover should make him pretty goddamn important. But apparently not important enough to be in the goddamn demo.
Well blocked. Pressure really on. Yet another corner.
Neymar wins another corner.
This point.
Rain. Just wide of the post.
From that distance.
They keep showing Ronaldo. I guess that he's on a hat trick. But
Doherty.
Like maybe Ronaldo is winning these headers and not Rain. Because it seems like those two are always like kind of clashing over the wall. Oh well, it doesn't matter. The foreign. Well, when is the final score? Damn it! Chelsea did get their second goal, but Swansea didn't. Disappointing, Swansea. Disappointing. Anyway. That is the end of this episode. But thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button. Do subscribe if you're new to this. In the next episode, but I will be playing Chelsea and Coventry in the Capital One and FA Cups, respectively. Until then, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace!